Modern science has taught mankind to treat the world carefully, but this is not a lesson he has always understood. Land was the source of all his treasure. It was there to be exploited. In early times, man lived in small communities, cultivating the land on which he lived to sustain him for all his needs. As he grew more sophisticated and learned to use weapons, communities became city-states, city-states formed alliances, and alliances bred empires, whose rise and fall form an undulating pattern throughout the history of the world. Empires depend on conquest, man's passion to acquire new territory.
Napoleon is one of history's most modern conquerors. Talleyrand, his foreign minister, remarked that his career was the most extraordinary that had existed for 1,000 years. Certainly there seems to be no one quite like him since Charlemagne, 1,000 years before, or Julius Caesar, nearly 1,000 years before that. But he was more than just a conqueror. He always claimed that he wanted to bring the greatest ideals of the French Revolution, liberty and equality, to the rest of Europe. His introduction of the Civil Code in 1804 was a monumental achievement, providing his country with an entirely new system of law based on the rights of individual citizens. After his final defeat at Waterloo in 1815, he was sent into exile to the remote British island of St. Helena in the South Atlantic, where he ruminated on his vivid career. "I had risen from the masses too suddenly," he said. "I felt my isolation." He died on the island in 1821.